Thank you. bring me down the trail of the twisters. It was a trail that eventually led me to WHNT.
A new severe thunderstorm warning. This is Morgan County.
And to the series you're going to see all this week on News Channel 19 at 6 and 10. I'm going to show you up close what we found on our trip through Oklahoma.
But that is definitely a wall cloud coming down right now, so we're going to watch.
And how you can tell when the weather's becoming dangerous. You'll look into the face of a tornado in some amazing pictures captured by storm chasers.
Okay, the main tornado is just to our northeast. It's submerged.
And you'll see the devastation these storms can bring.
My brother's. It's messed up. My brother's car.
On the trail of the twisters, it's part of News Channel 19's mission to give you the information that could save your life.
You need to get away from walls, get away from windows, and put some walls between you and the outside if you're in a trailer.
A mission that began when I was a five-year-old boy, huddled underground with my family, waiting for the storm.
I'm happy.
It's dark.
No, look. Look at this lawn.
It's almost a funnel cloud.
MedCom, you will not be able to come in on Balmoral. Multiple power lines down. We have people stuck also.
Hot weather.
It's your drive.
It's your
drive. Come on.
They can strike at any time of the day, any time of the year, and almost anywhere. And tornadoes can be at their deadliest right here in our area.
Tornado Alley sees more tornadoes. Even though the warning goes out early, many people just don't pay attention.
That's why it's so important for you to know as much as you can about what causes tornadoes and how to protect yourself. And it's also why I return to the Trail of the Twisters to try to give you an up-close look at these powerful storms.
If you want to see a tornado, this is the place.
The sunset eventually gives way to lightning.
Mother Nature's putting on a real lightning show here in East Texas tonight, but the threat of tornadoes is now rapidly diminishing. It's a very lucky day to catch a tornado in the high plains, and like most chases, we came up empty on this one.
At nightfall, a new wave of tornadoes starts sweeping the south. In Alabama, they slash through Guin, Jasper, Lafayette, heading north toward Huntsville.
Here's the latest bulletin, Nell. A hook echo indicating tornado activity has now located over northern Lawrence County. A tornado is on the ground at Langtown, or 26 miles west of the city of Huntsville, taking everything along as it goes.
In Huntsville, Civil Defense Director Harris Mitchell already has the Emergency Operating Center on alert.
Give it to Philip and have him plot it on the map. Mr. Wiseman,
here we are.
Put the warning out again.
Persons in trailer courts and mobile homes elsewhere are urged to evacuate and get to a place of safety.
Is anyone in there? You better take cover. There's a tornado coming.
A tornado is visible here at the airport. Projected path next few minutes will put it in the Harvest, Tony, Meridianville, Hazel Green areas of the county.
We got a spotted headed our way.
This thing is probably up above the worries. Now you can see it by clouds flash. It is down.
Echo 41 Huntsville. Hit by this tornado. It's almost on top. I think about it for right now.
The first touchdown comes at Harvest, a small crossroads community west of the city.
This house is completely gone, and then there's three more brick houses here completely gone.
The searchers find three victims, a mother and her two small children, their bodies blown and tumbled a quarter mile through the muddy fields. A grieving father, still alive, but with a broken back.
Got a big fall spotted north of a big one. I can hear it now.
George, you better get out there in a hurry, because
A second twister has cut through the harvest area, right on the heels of the first. And the injured begin pouring into Huntsville Hospital.
Agnew Ambulance Service has just asked other ambulances and surrounding communities to come and give assistance. All available ambulances in Huntsville are now dispatched to the tornado scenes. They need your help.
Soon, blood supplies begin to run low.
And we're running out of O positive and O negative.
All right, how many O negative do you need?
Huntsville Hospital is running dangerously low on their supply of blood. The Red Cross is opening their blood center. They ask that blood donors report to 701 Andrew Jackson Way immediately.
We need some help up here. We've had four different tornadoes to hit us, and there's another one on the way. Can you send us up some blood by Highway Patrol?
At 10:50, an enormous new funnel.
What's its course?
Directly as.
Well, let's get out of here.
Now, you can see this tornado very plain. It's coming just about straight in toward the park right now. How fast is it moving? It's moving fast. The first sighting of the Governor's Drive at the Space Museum, Colonel. Space Museum is the first sighting. Mr. Wiseman?
The tornado keeps coming through the heart of town, directly toward Huntsville Hospital.
The tornado heading for the hospital. Get inside and get out.
Get this patient inside. Get everybody away from the windows.
We're going to have to roll you out in the hall for just a few minutes. Hang on now.
Are there any casualties with the one on Governor's Drive yet?
Not any so far, no. Seem to be following the easterly path toward Parkway City Shopping Center.
It's on the ground all the way?
Still on the ground.
Dispatch somebody to the hospital.
Get Colonel Dindy on the phone.
How many injuries?
Get the National Guard out.
41 Hospital, advise him that there's power lines all down. We can't get out of here.
10-4 Civil Defense and HPD have been notified.
We got about five trailers overturned here.
It took the roof off this grocery store. Put the power lines down. Debris all over the highway.
Brandenburg. It looked like this in the morning.
We had a tornado. That would be the understatement of the year.
Oh my goodness, it just popped and cracked just like a hundred.